As I mentioned earlier, Mr. Lew, I am committed to strengthening Social Security and Medicare to ensure these programs will be there for future generations. The President has made some bold proposals in his budget to reform both programs. The President's proposal calls for Medicare cuts well above the level passed in the Senate budget. In the Senate budget, but a firewall around Social Security. I'm disappointed by the President's proposal to change how cost of living adjustments are calculated for seniors and military retirees. Cutting Montana seniors' benefits without asking the wealthiest Americans to chip in to the Social Security Trust Fund isn't right. Any reform of Social Security should be for the solvency of the program, not deficit reduction.
I wonder if you could explain how your change CPI works, the proposal. As I understand, it's about a 0.3% reduction in cost of living beginning 2015. Then there are other provisions for those over age 75, which I can't quite comprehend. But if you could explain, what is it? And, you know, let's take someone in Butte, Montana, who's about 65, let's say 67 years old. What reduction in benefits will she receive in beginning 2015? What dollar reduction she received? And I suppose it's compounded, too. So over time, when she gets a little older, I don't know what happens going through the age 75 window and then out of the window and so forth. But explain what it is, please, and how much reduction will this lady in Butte, Montana expect to see in her Social Security paycheck? And I raise it also in the context of, I'm a little concerned that this is I don't know if you can answer the question, that change CPI has been used partially to reduce the debt. My view very strongly is that Social Security should be handled outside of debt and deficit reduction. And second, I don't know why I don't see it in this proposal, you don't increase the cap on earnings at a higher rate. To me, that's a lot more fair how to find more revenue for Social Security Trust Fund than it is to reduce the benefits that this lady in Butte, Montana is going to get beginning 2015. So explain the proposal, please.
What change CPI does is it just changes the way we measure inflation increases. It doesn't actually cut anyone's benefit from what it is today. It changes the measure by which inflation increases will be given in the future.
Otherwise would be.
What changes with inflation increases will be in the future.
But she'll receive less than she otherwise would receive.